I want to walk you through how to set up your IM6000 system for connectivity to any RS232 input device. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually walk you through as if you've got no experience whatsoever with RS232 or any of that sort of stuff, and I'll show you everything you need in order to get the data strings out, and then you can get it into whatever software you're trying to. So right now we're working on a fairly new system. First thing we have to do is we have to turn on the RS232 outputs. In order to do that, go to Optional Settings, and then go to Measurement Output. Down here at the very bottom is a Transfer the Measurement Results to the IM Data Transfer. And this is essentially the serial communication, you see here, by using serial communications. So click that, and that'll turn on the capability for you to do that. On the rear of your system, there's something called Port 1. It's an RS232 port. It's a 9-pin connector that you'll need to plug your cables into, and if you're using the IMH1T software, all the cables come with it in the kit. If you want to make some fine-tune adjustments to how it works, what you'll do is once you're here at Optional Settings, I want you to hold Control, Shift, and the letter S, as in Sam. Control, Shift, S will bring up your RS232 output settings screen. Serial, you'll notice, is already selected. If you go to Advanced Settings, here's where you can set up some of the different communication settings. I don't want you to touch any of these. In fact, this should be at 115.200, and if it's not, please change it to that, as this is the fastest communication method that you can use. A lot of software will use 9600. That's really slow. If you think about it, this is actually how much information is going to travel in a single second, so obviously we want the biggest one possible. Click OK. Now, you can also hit Format Setting here. What this will do, it gives you the ability to change what information is going to be outputted in that RS232. So here you can take a look at the format and see exactly everything that's coming out. If you're looking for your actual measured values, they're going to be right over here. Your names, design values, upper lower spec limits, judgment values are right here. So if you're looking for OKs, no goods, that sort of thing. And then checksums are for RS232 equipment that needs to make sure it got all the information. That's what these values over here are. It basically just says, yep, I got everything. So you can fidget with these if you want to remove certain things. Maybe we don't need the names of each of the measurements. We don't need the measurement units. We don't want design values. You know, all we really want is just those values, those finished final measurement numbers. So that this is going to kind of be like a caliper or something along those lines. So I can actually select these. I'm removing all those different columns. I can turn off the header if I want. And now the only thing that'll spit out is just this, these four numbers. So I'm going to leave this by default for right now. It gives us the best functionality. But that's how that operates. Just hit OK, hit Close, and now you're done, as far as getting the data out of the IM itself. So what I'm going to do is switch over to my laptop, and I'll show you how to set up everything on the other half of the system. Okay, so what we've done is I took the IMH1T cable, but really all you need is any RS232 cable that goes into a USB port. Sometimes they're called key span adapters or just serial to USB adapters. You can find them on Amazon for $15, $20. They're not a whole lot, not expensive. The one thing you have to guarantee, though, is you're looking for something that's called a null modem, N-U-L-L, modem cable. What a null modem cable lets you do is it allows two devices to talk to each other as opposed to needing something in the middle that can do some translating. It's about $1 from Amazon to get a null modem adapter, or you can even buy just RS232 to USB null modem cables, which is what's in the IMH1T bundle that you might purchase. Now, for anybody who's not familiar with doing RS232 connectivity, it's not too difficult. In fact, this is the same communication that's been on computers for the last 30 years. What we're going to do is use a software called Putty, and you just go to www.putty.org. And you can download this free software. It's a very, very simple, very basic software. So I have Putty right here. I've downloaded it. I'm just going to double click on it. And here it is loading up. Now, first thing I need to do is I need to figure out what USB port I have plugged into. best way to do that is actually go to your control panel. You can do that by going to the Start menu. From Start menu, go to Control Panel, and then from here, go to Device Manager. In your Device Manager, you'll see Ports, COM and LPT. If you expand that, you'll see your USB, USB and serial converter. So mine is on COM 3. Yours will be on a different COM depending on how you've plugged it in. You just need to know what that COM number is. Alright, so what I'm going to do is click on Serial, and then type in whatever that COM number is, COM 3. Then I'm going to hit 115200 so that I have that set up to the correct speed, and hit Open. And what it gives me is a COM port. Now, I'm going to switch back over to the system real quick, and I've just got some video capture software going. So I'm going to go to multi-measurement. Let me make this full screen so you guys can see everything. All right, so here's our part. I'm just going to hit measure. And here's Putty. Broop. Everything populates. That's literally it. At this point, I've got all my information. So what we have here, this ST is start. SE is the serial number of the IM system itself. DA would be the date and the time. MS, that stands for measurement settings, is the name of the program. So if you'll notice here that the program's called part 12345, there's the program name. LO is lot number. SC is serial counter. CH is where the name will go, that's character. And the IT is item. And here's your values. 11.325, 11.325, diameter 001, diameter 001. This is the nominal value, upper limit, lower limit, and then here's where your OKs and no goods show up. So in this case, I have two OK and one no good part. It then ends with EN for end. That's it. If I hit the measure button a second time, a new string of data. Again, start, serial number, date, part, so on and so forth the whole way down. That's it. So the only thing you'd have to do at this point is whatever software you're trying to get to collect this RS-232 information, in this case we used Putty, but if you were using something like a National Instruments LabVIEW software or a PLC or anything along those lines, just do the exact same thing we did on Putty in that software. So it'll ask you what's the COM number, tell it what that COM number is, tell it what the speed is, hit open, and you are all set. Literally, that's all there is to RS-232 communication. It's not very complicated.